Oh, it looks so good. Smile. Does it hurt, like, at all?
Yeah.
You, like, seemed so calm.
Mine doesn't matter.
What?
Mine doesn't matter.
So, fill us in on your recent adventures, everything.
Well, I mean, the biggest one was I got a tattoo today.
Aw, yeah. It's been a long time coming.
It has, so I think many people are surprised. I actually did it, including myself. But I figured, you know, no time like the present, and a cool story it would be to get a year and, like, meaningful, I think. And, yeah, so I did it here.
Wow, were you super nervous?
And yeah, I had to speak in Spanish. Like, I'm so happy that I had, thankfully, Katie was kind enough to Photoshop a little something-something for me, which helped a lot.
I should, like, insert a picture of that and then your tattoo.
Yeah, definitely. Because it helps, I think, for the tattoo artist and for me to explain what it was. And then, yeah, I mean, I kind of told them I just wanted the lines a little thinner and the world a little more centered. And so I have, like, the bottom of North America, the top of South America, Africa and Asia, so I would like it. I mean, it's crazy. I, like, keep looking out at it. I'll show you guys. And it's, like, crazy it's there. Like, I feel like it's not real. But, I mean, it hurt, but, like, it wasn't as bad. It wasn't that bad. Like, I feel like I've felt pain worse. I mean, it kind of just feels like it's, like a little razor's just, like, scratching you. So, which is kind of, I guess, what I expected to feel like. Well, I like it.
How long did it take?
Okay, so I got in there around 11:30, and I was done by, like, 12:30.
Cool.
Because it took about, like, 20 minutes to draw it out, and then, so he looked at the picture and, like, stenciled it out and, like, looked up a picture of the world and, like, then drew it in. And then we sat down and he, like, put this, like, it was kind of like almost like a sticker. It was made into a sticker. So then he stenciled it onto my leg,
mm-hmm.
or my foot, I mean. And then that's when we, like, chose the colors. And I, like, sat on this high chair and he sat on a smaller chair, and my foot was, like, on his lap, I guess.
Okay.
Kind of weird, but yeah. And then he just went for it.
And cool.
I was like, oh my god. Well, and the ironic part was there was this girl sitting behind me who was getting a tattoo removed at the same time I was getting a tattoo. Want to publicly apologize to any family members I have disappointed, but you know, I am okay with it.
So what did your mom say?
She knew it was coming.
Yeah.
She's known this is coming for a while. And I told her yesterday and she was like, okay. And then whenever I showed the picture to her, she's like, I thought you were getting the inside of your right foot. I was like, you really gonna say that to me right now? I was like, yeah, that's going to be hard to cover up. Well, I like it. So, and then I think she was just trying to be annoying and it worked.
Just trying to be like a mom.
Yep, exactly. And then I told my grandma, which, Nana, I love you, but I'm sorry. I told my grandma, I said, hello, dearest grandmother. Or, hello, dearest me. Let me get verbatim. Hello, dearest grandmother. I must admit something to you. I love you, and I just got a tattoo. And she goes, are you kidding? What of and where? So, yeah. Sorry, but then she seemed to be okay with it, I guess. Put my hair back. So yeah, that was my crazy adventure today, and last weekend was the Chilean Independence Day, and so some friends and I went to this town about an hour and a half from here called Valparaiso, and it's really pretty. It's like just, it's like a town just full of art. It's so crazy. I'll send pictures. It's so beautiful. I think it's one of my favorite cities I've ever been to. It's like just so pretty. You just like walk around, and it's like light graffiti, but it's not graffiti, but it's like, it's just on the walls, on the floor, on the stairs, and it's art, and it's pretty, and it's colorful, and it's so cool.
That
it's
sounds like cool.
It's, yeah, I'll see the pictures, and yeah, it was fun. And so for the Independence Day, it's like, I had classes. I only had 2 days of class last week, and so that was cool. And then basically for Independence Day, they like, it's like a whole week of celebrating, like not due to day here in Chile. And it's full of like, the grocery store is closed for 2 days, like completely closed. So if you want food, you have to like buy it in advance, like stock up.
Interesting.
Like fondas, which are kind of, they have like fair food and different drinks. They have what's called a terremoto, which is pineapple ice cream, like a grenadine, and wine. And it's sweet and very dangerous. It's like, it makes you feel quite intoxicated. So I would eat one and I'm good. And then, yeah, I don't know, it's cool. Everyone just walks around. They chant, like, so the thing that people do is you say, chi chi chi, le le le, viva Chile. So that was chanted quite a lot. I think that's similar to USA, USA, USA.
Well, that sounds fun.
Yeah, so it does. It does. Or it was fun. I enjoyed it.
Well, I'm going to wrap up the vlog portion of this.
Yes, sorry.
So, thank you for the update.
Hello. You're welcome, and thank you, YouTube, for accepting me.
Alrighty, peace, fellow YouTubers.